who can you trust when the ones who are blocking your life like these?
The fact remains that we got a lot of work to do, and the niggas exist, and the kids now, when they use the word nigga, it's an endearment. It's like, man, that's my nigga. If you don't get no bigger, you know, this is beautiful. I mean, it's like, and we can say it in such lovely ways. We say it in such lovely ways that white folks just wanna say nigga so bad. And then some of them have crossed over and they've hung out with enough black folks to say nigga. I mean, I heard a guy say nigga the other day that was amazing. This is a white guy who we call the white nigga, who, I mean, they got these other names, Wigger up in White Plains, but this guy, I don't even think he would buy that. He wanted to be a nigga. He said, yo, man, like, man, this Greek nigga, he's talking about this Greek nigga, then he's talking about this Japanese nigga, then he's talking about a Chinese nigga, then he talked about the Mexican nigga come out the kitchen in the restaurant. I mean, everybody was a nigga. And I was amazed when I was, I said, damn, this is amazing. He's just niggerized the entire world. Everybody's a nigga. But the nigga thing has grabbed the imagination of all of the people who feel like powerless, because the nigga is that character that could never be captured. He could never, even if he was in chains, he was gonna find a way to get out or be nasty somehow. He's still not gonna yield. The nigga is an unyielder, you know, so to speak. He's like somebody that's not gonna submit. He's nasty and arrogant and ruthless, and he's not giving in. This is an attitude of a nigga to some extent. This is what they've put. Black people are sweet and kind and lovely. You know, it's like it's a bit of a misnomer that they have had white folks afraid to come to our communities. And people, I would come to Harlem. Yeah, well, now they walk around Harlem with their little poodles, 2 o'clock in the morning, you know. So, but yeah, the nigga has been romanticized. We're not gonna be able to get rid of the nigga, and that's not the goal. We have to redirect the nigga and make it clear that we can all say nigga and whatever, like we do in our conversations, but understand who you really are. You're a black person, you're a black man, and that we only use black as a political comment, a statement. It's not, you don't come from black land, you're an African in America, we can go through all that stuff, but the bottom line is I like black because it's just solid, it's just clear. You know, it doesn't have any, it's not a color, it's strictly a political consciousness. You know, just like if you say you white, ain't nobody really white, it's just a political consciousness. I'm a white guy, I'm a white girl. No, you might act like Susie Cream Cheese, but I know some white people who act like Malika too. Because that's the flavor they picked up.